Hello all, welcome to my channel. Today I will demonstrate you how we can create our own color chooser panel with the J color chooser class. I want to develop the Java applications like this. For example, whenever user click on any color that I want to make it as a background color of my label. Even I want to provide the option like HSV, HSL, RGB, CMYK. So whenever user click on any color and choose the color, I want to make the effect into background of my label. So let's do the same thing practically. Let me save this program as testdemo.java. I want to create a one class, and that is a taste which extends from jframe. So I want to use the swing package over here. So to use the swing, we need to import javax.swing.star. So here I can access the jframe and j color chooser both. Now I want to use some control of AWT, that is abstract window toolkit. So I'm writing here java.awt.star. Now I want to create an instance of that is j color chooser. And here you can write j color chooser c equal to new j color chooser. So this will do what? It will create an instance of j color chooser. Now I want to create a constructor of taste class. We can write the code to close the frame. So I'm just writing here set default close operation is the function in which you can pass exit on close. Now I want to add this particular control, that is the color chooser. So what we can do, simply we can write here that is add C. So what C is? C is the instance of the color chooser, and that will be added to my frame. Now I want to call the frame. So I need to create the main class in which I can define the main method. So I'm creating here one class that is taste demo. Here you can write the main method, that is public static void main. Now here you can create an instance of taste, so your frame will be created. So I'm writing here taste t equal to new taste. What happened? It will call the constructor of the taste class. So superclass constructor will be called and your frame will be created. Here you can write t dot set bounds. Here you can set x, y, width and height. For example, my x is 100, y is 100, 600 width, 500 height. Here you can write t dot set visible true. Why? Because by default frame are hidden. You can save this. Now here you can just compile your program, that is testdemo.java, and you can run test demo. What happened? You will get the panel over here, that is the color chooser panel. But I don't want just panel. Whenever user click on any color, I want to set the text of my label also. So I need a label also. What we can do? For that, you can create an instance of label over here. So you can do what? You can create an instance that is J label LBL is equal to new J label is the class. Here you can write the content. For example, I want to write here that is Atmiya University MCA Rajkot. Now here you can set the content that where you want this content. So here you can set that jlabel.center. Now here we can add the label. So I can just write here add LBL, but by default the layout is the border layout. So what happened? Whenever you add the label over here, you can save this. You can compile your program and you can run. What happens? See, your label is not visible over here and your color chooser is visible here. Suppose if you are writing a color chooser that is above the label, you can save this. You can compile and rerun your code. Now your label will be displayed, but your color chooser will not be displayed. Reason is the default layout is the border layout. So how to resolve this particular thing? That is very simple. Here you can write that I want this color chooser at border layout dot south. So what happened? This color chooser will be added to south and this Atmi University MCA that will be available in the frame. So now you can compile your program, and whenever you compile and run your program, you will be able to display both, that is your label and your color chooser both. Now I want to do what? I want to set the foreground color of my label and I want to set the background color of my label. So here you can do what? Here you can write, that is label dot set, and you can set the foreground, for example, foreground, and here you can set the color, that is color dot white. So my label foreground color will be set as a white. I want to set background color of label also. Label dot set background, and here you can set, for example, color dot blue. You can save this. Now you can compile your program and run your code. What happened? This background is not blue, it is not affected over here, but foreground color is white. So I want the effect over here. If you want the effect in your label, then before adding the label, you can set the opaque method. So you can write here lbl.setOpaque is the function, and here you can pass true. By default, it is false. You can save this. You can compile your program and run. What happened? You will get here that the background color is blue, and this is my white foreground color Atmi University MCA. Now I want to increase the font of this label. So what we can do? I can call here function, that is lbl.setFont, and here you can call the constructor of font class in which you can pass the font name. So my font name is Times New Roman. Here you can set the font type, that is font dot bold, and here you can set the size, for example 30. You can save this. Now here you can compile and run your code. Atmi University MCA having the font, and that is Times New Roman with the size 30. Now whenever user click on any color, I want to set that particular as a background color of this label. So what we can do? For that, we need to implement the change listener, and it is available in the package, that is import java x dot swing dot event dot star, and here you can implement change listener. Change listener is an interface, so we need to implement the method. You can save this. You can compile your program. You will get an error, and the error will be what? State change method is not implemented. Why? Because this change listener is the interface. So I need to implement the method, and that is a state changed method. So what we can do? Simple. We can override here one method, and that is public void state changed. And here you can pass an instance of change event, that is CE. Now whenever user choose the color, I want to change the color of the label. So I can call directly here, that is label dot set background, in which you can pass, that is a C dot get color. So get color is the function, and what C is? C is my instance variable, that is I declared over here, that is J color chooser. Right, so whatever the color available in the J color chooser, that should be my label dot background. You can save this. You can compile your program, but what happened? Whenever you run this, you will not get the effect over here. For example, if you choose any color, that will not be set as a background. Why? Because I need to register my this listener, and that is the change listener. So how we can do this? It is very simple. C dot get selection model is the function dot add change listener. You can call, and you can pass the current instance, that is this. It means you can pass the instance of change listener over here. So it will automatically call the state change method whenever the color is a change into your color chooser. Now you can save this. You can compile your code and you can run. Now what effect will be there? Whenever you choose any color over here, it will be set as a background color of your label. Not only this, I can select the background color from here, and that you can select the color and you can change the effect over here. So this is the way you can use the JColor chooser of Swing into your application. So that's it from my side. If you like this video, then please like, share, and subscribe to my channel. Thank you very much. Have a nice day.